Today, I'm getting ready to take down one of the nodes in the cluster, and I'm going to be replacing that with Proxmox backup server. Now, that is a bare metal installation in and of itself, so you need a dedicated machine to that. So we're going to go through the steps today on how to remove a node, and then I'm going to do a future video on the entire setup of the Proxmox backup server itself. But I wanted to show people, if you have created a Proxmox cluster, the steps that you need to go through to physically move yourself off of that, make sure all of your replication jobs are finished, and then remove that node safely from the cluster without affecting anything or leaving any legacy junk behind, which is usually the biggest case problem that I've seen with me removing a cluster node member and forgetting to remove things like replication jobs for ZFS replication and stuff like that. So we'll start with going over what we're going to do here. So I'm going to move this Edge web host off of Prox 5. Now, Proxmox 5 is a R520, and the Dell R520 does have quite a variety of additional PCIe risers. These do come with some restrictions as far as what you can actually effectively fit in them, but you also have another one over here. You have Enterprise iDRAC. This is a great enterprise machine for the RAM utilization that you're using for being able to get up and running. I would not recommend you necessarily go out and buy one, but definitely Dell class machines that are the lower end spec can sometimes be really good for running as things like a backup server. This has 8 bays up front, so I can put quite a few hard drives in it. And it also has a 40 gigabit connection, and it has a SAS HBA in there, which is an external HBA, which connects to my tape library. That'll allow me to really nicely have the server power on, backup information, and then go ahead and move that off of there and onto the tape backup. As well, it's got a free slot, will be well utilized by an NVMe, and that NVMe is more likely going to be a temp directory for me to write to or buffer to as I'm writing to the tape, because you don't want to have intermittency in your writing. You want a really consistent stream when you're writing to tape, which is just kind of a quirk that you have when you're doing backups to tape. So we're going to go ahead and migrate this host by right-clicking. We're going to click Migrate. We're going to actually move this to Proc 0. I'm going to move this a little bit closer to the edge. So it's going to live on the virtual router machine here. So we're going to go ahead and migrate this machine now. It'll take just a few seconds for it to complete as it moves over the network. And even though it is a 40 gigabyte disk that is the raw image disk, only about 6.27 is utilized by physical bytes on the disk. So once we get to that point of 6.27, the entire rest of the process will move incredibly fast. And so the R520 has been in use for quite some time, and it is a nice server. It also has some E5 2670 V2 processors, which are high performance, and it has tons of RAM in it, so it can easily buffer things into that RAM and out of that RAM. Okay, so it looks like it has finished the migration process here. So I'm going to go ahead and close this out, and we can see that if we look at the Proxmox 5 node here in the cluster, have no virtual machines, no LXCs running on it. The next thing you want to do is click replication here and make sure you don't have any replication jobs. If you do, you need to remove them now with the highlight them and then click remove, and then you can recreate those later. If you don't do that, you will not be able to remove them from the other clusters that were impacted by that in whatever fencing you've arranged. So make sure you do that. And so this is the summary for this actual machine here. You can see that it's got 40 essentially vCPUs, and it has E5 2470 V2, two sockets occupied, and it has 192 gigabytes of RAM, which comes out to about 188 gigabytes. So at this point, we can go ahead and power off the node. As soon as the node is powered off, you're going to go ahead and remove it. However, if you note, I'm logged into 203 here. This is essentially Proxmox 3. If I was logged into 205, that would actually be the physical server itself in the cluster. So I don't want to do that. I want to be logged into a different node in the cluster so that I can remove it from the shell there. So we're going to go ahead and power this down now. So we'll go ahead and shut this down. And as soon as this turns to red, we're going to go ahead and open up a terminal in our Proxmox 3 machine over here. So I'm just going to click on shell really quick, and that'll bring up the terminal window here. So you can do a couple of things if you need to know which node it is, but you should pretty much know the node name. In my instance here, the node name will be Prox5. It will be whatever the node name is that is displayed over here that you're going to use for deleting this. And so the command is pvecm del node, and then Prox5 will be what we type here. And so after that, it will go ahead and kill the node. Now, you can't repower this machine back up and have it reconnect to the same network. So you need to physically remove the boot drives at this point in time so that it doesn't come back up and try to rejoin. And in our instance, that's going to happen in the next video that I'm doing, which is setting up the Proxmox backup server and configuring it so that it can do its backups. And so we're going to do one more thing here to just check the status and make sure that we are looking good here. And that's going to be pvecm status. And you're going to see that we are core 8. We have our Spacemox cluster here, and we also have 5 total votes on those machines. And you can see the naming that we have 200 to 204 now. The 205 has been removed. That will be replaced with the Proxmox backup server itself. And you can see the node IDs that we have down here. So at this point, you can go ahead and close that out. You can also go to your data center, and if you go to your cluster, you can see your Proxmox nodes will be listed here as well. And you no longer see the Proxmox 5 node listed. We will go ahead and recreate another cluster member and call it Prox5 after we get the backup server running here so that we can get some additional layers of backup security. It's been taking a really long time to do uploads to OneDrive right now for some reason on my network. It's just been choked up. So I definitely need to get back into doing offsite backups with the tape library. And I don't have anything that's super recent. I think October was the last time I did that. So that's way too long. And I thought I was going to be able to move to like an rsync thing with Duplicati in OneDrive. But for some reason, that's just slowed down quite a bit lately. I do hope to get that figured out as well. So make sure to hit like and subscribe if you have not done that so that you can follow along with that as we do a little bit more deep diving on Proxmox itself on the Spacemox Proxmox cluster that I've created here, which is using 56% of 230 CPUs right now, 75% of 1 tibibyte of RAM, and 38% of 6 tibibytes of NVMe storage. We're going to be doing some stuff on it. We're going to do some other exciting things. So make sure you do hit that like and subscribe. Leave me a comment below if you have some specific things you would like to learn about Proxmox, especially some of the things around the new SDN. I'm very interested in that. And I'm going to have kind of a few different networks going on this. And so I want to cover things that are relevant to the audience. So drop me a comment below and make sure you have a great rest of your day.